Welcome back to Close Up. Norma Love has spent 31 years covering the New Hampshire State House for the Associated Press, but on Friday, she left the press room for the last time and now begins retirement. So now we look back with Norma on her career in three decades of New Hampshire politics. Thanks so much for coming in.
Nice to see you, James.
So you must have a mix of emotions. You've been celebrated by the governor, the legislature for all your years in service. That must make you feel pretty good. But what are you thinking about this last week?
It got a little sad for me. I mean, you think about a whole decade of covering the first, coming to New Hampshire was not my first career. I spent some time on California and upstate New York and on the globe for a year. So I had that 7 years, and then I came to New Hampshire, and I just thought, well, I'll be here a year or two. Well, that was 31 years ago, and I got really into covering the State House. I spent 29 years there. So it's a career change for me to say bye-bye, open a door, and maybe there'll be something down the way I want to do part-time, maybe not. But I just felt like it was time. I felt the clock was ticking, and it was time to go. So today, this week, last week, whatever, it's just been kind of a culmination, and it got pretty sad. I choked up in the Senate when they read their proclamation. It was just everybody was standing there, and I was like, wow, I'm not used to being the center of attention, and I got very blushed. In fact, people have been working very hard to make me blush lately.
Well, that's good. It is well deserved. You actually brought this up a little bit there. How did you get this job? What's the process of the thinking of how this happened in the first place?
You mean in terms of coming to the
29 state? Years ago, yeah.
Well, I had been helping Joe Magruder, who was the State House person before me, and see, I was his second. I would come over. I would do like Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays when things were really busy, and then he got promoted to be the news editor, and I got promoted to being the State House person. And the first year, I ran back and forth between the Concord bureau down the street and the State House, and I realized that really doesn't work. You really have to immerse yourself in the State House, in the culture. These people are volunteers. They like to think that you're there and you're one of them. And so once I did that, it just kind of unfolded. The issues are really what interested me more than the politics. I know lots of people like to focus on the spin. And I remember one time I was covering a campaign, and one of the campaign people came out and said, "Oh, Norma Love, no spin for you." And because you need to cut through that stuff, and that's why that I really like the issues a lot more than I did the politics.
Yeah. Was there any secrets that you learned early on that, you know, this is the way I need to cover it by attending committee meetings, for example, or maybe making personal phone calls instead of just meeting people in the hallway, you're working with lobbyists? Were there certain things you learned early on that were really key?
Everybody, I think, covers it a little differently. For me, when I started out, I went to a lot of committee hearings. I lived in the budget room when they were doing the budget. I mean, I spent weeks, hours, days, particularly in the House, when the House would work on the budget, because by the time it would reach the Senate, a lot of the stuff was pretty well known, where the cuts were going to be or where they were going to fight over them. But it's really all about relationships, and you develop those relationships by showing, one, that you care, that you think what they're doing is important, that you respect them no matter whether your personal feelings are in odds with them, because it evolves into something where sometimes your best, closest relationships are opposite from you politically. I'll give you an example. Donna Sitek, a lot of her positions over the years, she was a House Speaker, Republican. We've talked about it. We disagree. We're having lunch next week because we become really close friends over the years. So you have to separate. And I remember one time someone came downstairs and said to me that someone in her speaker's office was upset because Norma Love had written something about her. And she said, "Well, Norma's doing her job." And I think that really tells you a lot about why relationships are important in any kind of journalism. It's not about me, it's about them. And if you can decide up front it's not about you, you'll do well.
And the key here was when you sat down after hours and hours in a budget meeting and knowing that your story is going to go around the state, it's going to obviously have an impact in terms of how people are going to think about what the dynamic, what the current fight might be about. The reality is a lot of people don't pay much attention to what's happening to the sausage making in the State House. So were you trying to write for the audience inside the State House as their dean, or were you always trying to think, you know what, there's a person in Auburn who needs to understand what's going on?
I always thought about the person in Auburn. Mm-hmm. I think that there are people who write columns I never did, and I think that they have a place, they have a mm-hmm. role. For me, it was always about the person outside of the State House, because, you know, there's 424 people, and the ideas that they bring to the State House aren't necessarily always their own. They may be a constituent, and there's mm-hmm. usually an issue behind it. So if you can find what's behind it, for example, sometimes I would get helpers over the years, and in the last few years, we've done some stories about the state of the roads and the potholes mm-hmm. that we all hit. I had a helper that I said, you know, let's go out and find out what would it mean to a community if they had to close a bridge. And that's what he did. He went out and found out what it meant to that town to close a bridge if they didn't have the state aid to fix it. And they ended up using property tax money to try and keep it open.
Was there a bigger story you had the most fun with? You had
most
a lot of governors.
Fun. I don't know if I'd call
we had
it
the impeachment of a Supreme Court. We had the Claremont. I mean,
I don't know that I call those the most fun. I think the most there were two stories that are the most meaningful to mm-hmm. me. And back in the early 90s, I did a series on how rape prosecutions varied by county. So if you were a woman and you were raped in one county, you might be treated with dignity, and if you were in another county, you might not be. And I'm most proud of those stories because some of those county attorneys that were not so good got unelected. And I think over the years the laws changed, maybe in small part to that. The second series or group of stories was gay marriage. I think that was historic. If I had to say what was the top issue that I covered, I would say that was it. I can still remember when House Speaker Terry Norelli announced the vote, no one expected the bill to pass, mm-hmm. and it was 182 to 183, and everybody gasped. What do we do now? Because you can't, it had to have a motion. You can't leave a bill in limbo. So the motion was made to table it. That failed. The motion was made to kill it. That failed. So there was a break, and then they talked about, you know, what do we do, and came back, and they voted to reconsider the first vote, which failed. And it passed, and that kind of set that on a torturous road to being mm-hmm. approved. I mean, they thought it would die in the Senate, and now Governor Maggie Hassan was instrumental in seeing that it did not. It reached John Lynch, who said, well, who was personally opposed to gay marriage, but called all the reporters into his office and said, if you protect these churches and religious groups, I'll sign this bill, otherwise I'll veto it. So the legislators did that, and it was signed. I think that was probably the one that gave me the most goosebumps.
You have about a few seconds left here. I wanted you to talk about, are you concerned about the state of the press in New Hampshire now?
I am concerned about the state of the press generally. AP will fill my position. I think that we need to cover the government. We need to be the watchdog on government, and I'm concerned that fewer and fewer organizations are doing that.
Great. Norma Love, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Enjoy retirement. Hope you have a great time.
Thank you.
Well, that wraps up this edition of Close Up New Hampshire.